46% of Filipino adults believe their quality of life will improve in a year. That's according to a recent study by the social weather stations. 44% of respondents believe their quality of life will stay the same, while 5% think it will worsen. Now, this resulted in a net optimism rate of 41% due to increased optimism in Luzon and Visayas. The survey polled 1,500 Filipinos from June 28th to July 1st. Also at the ASEAN GCC summit, President Marcos presented the country's controversial sovereign wealth fund to Saudi Arabian businessmen. Marcos presented the Maharlika Investment Fund at a roundtable meeting on investment opportunities in the Philippines. Marcos told the business leaders he looks forward to benefiting not just from Saudi investments, but also from the kingdom's extensive experience in fund management. Marcos earlier this week suspended the implementation of the Maharlika Investment Fund law, but he has vowed to ensure the fund will become operational by year end.
At the forefront of these opportunities is the recently launched Maharlika Investment Fund, the Philippines' first ever sovereign investment fund designed to drive long-term economic development through increased investments in high-impact sectors.
Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. joins fellow world leaders in the ASEAN Gulf Cooperation Council Summit, which officially opened today. The ASEAN GCC Summit is the first meeting of Southeast Asian leaders with their counterparts from the Gulf nations. Before the summit began, Marcos and his economic team held a roundtable with Saudi businessmen. The Philippine business delegation signed investment agreements worth over $4.26 billion. The agreements outline investments for human resource services and construction export services, among others. Moving on to other news, a family of an overseas Filipino worker killed in Jordan seeks the Philippine government's help in their request for justice, or in their quest for justice. According to Maria Lisa Santos, the mother of OFW Mary Grace Santos, her daughter's colleagues say she had been harassed by the 16-year-old son of her Egyptian co-worker. The teenager is currently under police custody as a prime suspect of the case. Authorities in Jordan found Mary Grace's body last week in the house where she worked.
Ang kwento po sa akin, sa amin nung pinaidyaan, hindi po kasi nagkukwento si Grace sa amin. Ang kwento daw po niya, lagi daw po siyang minamanyak nung Egyptian na yon. Matapang si Grace, matapang. Malakas, pero siguro mas malakas yung pumatay sa kanya, kaya hindi na niya nagawang ipaglaban pa ang sarili niya. Pero kawawa siya. Kawawa. Every time na iniisip ko kung paano siya pinatay, kung paano siya sinasaktan, bilang isang ina talagang napakasakit. Napakasakit po.
The second batch of Filipinos repatriated from Israel, now back home. An Etihad Airways flight carried 18 overseas Filipino workers. 14 of them are caregivers and 4 are hotel workers. That includes one OFW who was unable to join the first batch after failing to secure a medical clearance. The Migrant Workers Department earlier said the repatriated OFWs will receive financial and livelihood assistance, as well as psychosocial counseling. The so-called Oplan Baklas of the Commission on Elections now in full swing on the second day of the campaign period for the village and youth council polls. Our correspondent Victoria Tula joins us on the line with the details. Victoria?
Ron, Commission on Elections Chairman George Garcia led the removal of illegal campaign materials and their Oplan Baklas today in Barangay 312 and 310 in Mata. Garcia removed posters of candidates running in the village and youth council polls that were put on electric posts, a fence, and under the LRT. He was joined by other COMELEC officials and personnel from the Manila Local Government, Bureau of Fire Protection, and Philippine National Police. Garcia said they will file cases of illegal campaigning. The poll chief assured that they can handle the volume of complaints that might be brought to their office with the help of various government agencies. He also warned all elected officials, may they be in local or national positions, from supporting candidates. He said they may face cases from violating the code of conduct and ethical standards for public officials and employees and the Anti-Graft and Corrupt Practices Act. Meanwhile, Garcia confirmed the death of a barangay councilor Bet in Bukay Abra. He also said they received reports about the abduction in Parañaque City of the wife of a barangay chairman candidate in Abra. Garcia is awaiting the recommendation of the PNP whether to elevate Abra in the areas of concern. He is also waiting for updates on the status of Barangay Bagong Silangan in Quezon City, which might be downgraded to generally peaceful from immediate concern. The poll body chief warned people who want to disrupt the peace to not interfere. Ron?
Victoria Tulad with that story. Thanks. The Metropolitan Manila Development Authority releases a list of measures to alleviate traffic congestion during the upcoming holidays. The MMDA plans to activate its Oplan Undas 2023 on October 27 to ensure traffic order for the observance of All Saints Day. Nearly 1,500 traffic enforcers will be deployed in key areas in the metropolis. For the Christmas season, the MMDA will be temporarily suspending excavation activities across Metro Manila from midnight of November 13 to January 8, 2024. The nighttime duty of traffic enforcers will also be extended until midnight for the same time period. The agency will also be requiring shopping mall operators to submit traffic management plans for their sale events. Filipinos are warned against an illegal data collection scheme by persons pretending to be from the Statistics Office. The Philippine Statistics Authority issued the warning Friday after it learned of the illegal activity done through scanning national ID cards. The PSA denied conducting the activity and warned the public against giving out their details to persons claiming to be from the agency.